Band Performance USA, the greatest entertainers in America, is requested by you, the fighting men of the United States Armed Forces throughout the world. Command Performance, presented this week and every week, till it's over there. Okay there, men, the American Entertainment Front is lined up to fire that salute to the fighting fronts. And the stars of Hollywood are on deck to man the big guns loaded with the music and laughter of America in answer to your letters to Command Performance, care of Special Service Division, Los Angeles, USA. And swinging into the spotlight to lay down the opening barrage is our head man in the talk department tonight, the commanding officer of this Command Performance, Don Ameche.
Thank you, Ken Carpenter, and hello, fellas. We're traveling kind of heavy tonight, and we got plenty of ground to cover, so let's roll. First, a quick hello to Private Herb Barrickman and the 5th Air Force, to Dit and Da, the four radio rogues at 913, to Marconti and the 610 mob, to Sarge Yetter and nine guys packed into Hut 14 up there in Iceland, Lefty and the Bugs at 503, and, well, let's face it, to First Lieutenant Sanford Gloss at 903, who says, Command Performance is really lousy. Yes, fellas, every 1,000 letters to Command Performance, we get one that slaps us down. Hello, Wade Hanks and the P.T. Devils west of Frisco. The 954 Balloon Addicts. That's a new one, including Hank Vanderplow, Private Egghead Trinkle, Ed Tetzlaff, and Know-It-All Stone. Get set, everybody, for here comes one of the hottest trios in the land of jive. Solid Potato Salad and the King Cole Trio.
Some folks like their taters lyonnaise, some prefer french fries, but I like mine fixed with mayonnaise, coleslaw on the side. Solid potato salad, that solid side of Jack. Solid potato salad, boy, take one plate, fill it up, bring right back. Solid potato salad, and let's have no yak-yak. Solid potato salad, boy, take one plate, fill it up, bring right back. The farmer said to the spud, your skin looks slightly pallid, so I'll dig you later, bud. For some solid potato salad, solid potato salad, that solid salad, Jack. Solid potato salad, boy, take a plate, fill it up, bring right back. Take a plate, fill it up, bring right back. Take a plate, fill it up, bring it right back. Take a plate, fill it up, bring it right back. Solid potato salad, it is really fine, and you better latch on. Solid potato salad, don't hesitate, go get the plate before it's all gone. The farmer said to the spud, your skin looks slightly pallid, so I'll dig you later, bud. For some solid potato salad, that solid salad, Jack. Solid potato salad, boy, take a plate, fill it up. Take a plate, fill it up, bring it right back. Take a plate, fill it up, bring it right back.
Thank you, King Cole Trio. And fellas, right here, we're going to slip over something on you. A lot of you ask Command Performance, what's become of Jack Douglas? In fact, Jack Douglas asked me just this morning. Jack, or as close friends refer to him, Mr. Jack Douglas, is a singer. He sings to kill time and, brother, it's murder. Fellas, Jack Douglas.
Come on out, Jack.
Sweetest little fellow everybody knows. I don't know what to call him, but he's my hero.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm certainly happy to be here. Gee, just imagine me broadcasting on Command Performance. Why, it only seems like yesterday I was... Too soon. It seems like only yesterday I was picked up in the park for vagrancy. But it wasn't yesterday, it was Tuesday, and it wasn't vagrancy, it was larceny. I stole a squirrel away from a nut. Ah, radio, it's wonderful, but I'm worried about my mother. If she knew I was doing this for a living, she'd kill me. She thinks I'm an air raid warden. But my girl will sure be glad to hear that I'm working. She's a lovely girl, too. She's a pin-up girl. She hasn't got all of her buttons. She's a very pretty girl, though. She has her hair fixed just like Veronica Lake, you know, combed down over half her face. Well, the other day I got curious and lifted up her hair and looked under it, and what do you think? Wallpaper. I'll never forget the first time I met her. She was wearing a dyed rabbit fur. No, I'll take that back. I wasn't quite dead yet. She's an awfully sweet girl. We used to go on picnics together. Boy, what fun. I'd rather go on a picnic than eat.
Look, Jack, I hate to interrupt, but I've got something here that I should
wait
say.
Wait a minute, Don. I got a picture of my girl there. How do you like it?
Well, say, she's very pretty, but what's that she's wearing?
That's a strapless bathing suit.
A strapless bathing suit? How does she keep it up?
Soybeans. Well, she's a lovely girl, and I know she'd be glad to hear that I'm on the radio. At last, I've been discovered.
Well, she should be proud of you, Jack, but of course you would have been discovered much sooner if you'd gotten around more, done things, met people.
Oh, I did, Don. Only a few days ago, I made a personal appearance at the blood bank.
Did they take your blood?
Of course they took my blood.
Well, they can always use it for a chaser. But what I meant, Jack, was, have you made any personal appearances in the entertainment field?
Well, I tried that, Don. I tried that. One night I sang on the sidewalk outside of Zero's.
Yeah, but, Jack, why didn't you sing inside?
That's where I started. Please watch it, Don. I get upset very easily. And besides, I come from a very sad family.
Oh, you do, huh?
Yes, I'll never forget the day I was born. Bang, 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 bang.
Bang, 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 bang. What about your mother?
You mean pistol packing mama? You know, Don, I don't like to admit it, but I wasn't a very pretty baby. For weeks, nobody could figure out whether I was animal, vegetable, or Orson Welles.
You know, Jack, you interest me. Tell me more about your childhood, will you?
Well, you should have seen me when I was a kid, Don. I had long gray curls and short rides on my bicycle.
Well, now, wait. Wait a minute, Jack. When you were a kid, you had long curls?
Yes, and from the back, I looked like a girl. It was very confusing. When I got my first pair of long pants, I started following myself. And shortly after that, I became a prize fighter. And you should have seen me in my prize fighting days. What a body. Muscles all the way up to my wrist. I'll never forget my first fight. What training I went through. I worked like a dog. I was in bed every night with the chickens and up every morning with the eggs. Then came the night of the big fight. The stadium was packed. What a crowd. What celebrities. Everybody that was anybody was someplace else. I climbed through the ropes and took a look at the guy I was going to fight. Oh, boy.
He was big, huh?
Big. It was the first time I ever saw a steam shovel with hair. The next thing I knew, the bell rang and my opponent dashed out of his corner. I dashed out of my corner. He caught me in the balcony. What a fight. He hit me. He hit me. He hit me. He hit me. Then I hit him. Then we mixed it up in the center of the ring. Boy, what a battle. And then it happened. Foul.
Well, now, wait a minute, Jack. Foul?
Yes, he ripped my bloomers.
Well, that takes care of Jack Douglas, and thanks a lot, Jack. And here's the 43rd Army Air Force's Orchestra of Gardner Field playing Saludos Amigos.
Thank you.
a hello next to the 7 Come 11 Club at 634. Marion Roberts and the British at Boredom Wood, Elstree Hertz. Howdy, H.J. Carr and the Joe Pot Gang of that patrol squadron care the postmaster San Francisco. Hi there, White Heat Hawley at 680 and Warehouse 8 at 923. Greetings to Willie the Wolf of West Virginia, to the crew of Casey's Baby at 760. To 960 and Uncle Dam, Rossello, Abby, Slats, Maddie, Bull, Ebby, and Possum. Those letters to command performance from APOs and FPOs everywhere ask, what's the rage on the radio? What song is getting the big play? Well, men, there's a new song that's already part of American slang. In the old days, when your girl answered the phone, she'd say, this is your ever-loving. Today, she picks up the receiver and yells, this is your pistol-packing mama. The guy who wrote it, singing it for the AEF, Al Dexter and his pistol-packing mama.
Hello, fellas. How do you do?
Drinking beer in the cabaret and was having fun. Until one night she caught me right and now I'm on the run. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down. She kicked out my windshield, she hit me over the head. She cussed and cried and said I'd lied and wished that I was dead. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down. Cabaret and dancing with a blonde. Until one night she shot out the light. Bang, that blonde was gone. Lay that pistol down, babe. Lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama. Lay that pistol down. I'll see you every night, babe. I'll woo you every day. I'll be your regular dad if you'll put that gun away. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down. Morning, the clock was ticking four. Gun in the hand says you're my man, but I don't need you no more. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down. Now there was old Al Dexter, he always had his fun. But with some lead she shot him dead, his honking days are done. Lay that pistol down, babe, lay that pistol down. Pistol packing mama, lay that pistol down.
Thank you, Al Dexter. Command performance gets a lot of letters from the Merchant Marine. And we want to reassure you men of the saltwater infantry who tramp back and forth across the seas that your job rates as high as any of this war. Sailing those ships loaded with bad news for the Axis is a tough assignment. So tonight we send a salute to the Merchant Marine from part of the Merchant Marine itself. Yes, sir, it's the famous quartet you once knew as the Vagabonds, now with the U.S. Merchant Marine Cadet School at San Mateo, California. Fellows, a Tahitian chant called Marcel Vahini and the Merchant Marine Four.
Marcel Vahini. Hey, I'm a man, I'm a man,
And part two of the Merchant Marine Corps doing their stint for the Merchant Marine around the world. Their own version of that great old ditty and a favorite of Gene Autry, Bing Crosby, and everybody in Great Britain. Here they are.
Ladies and gentlemen, being of the festivity season, it's with a great deal of pleasure that we pause and pay tribute to some of the masters who've left us some real fine works. So to these masters, we dedicate this classical selection.
Skies are gray. You never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
The other night, I was having a dream. Oh, what a lovely dream it could be. I was dreaming about a girl in white. Now, there she was in my loving arms. You really never know how much I'm really gonna miss her. Don't ever do it. Don't ever take her away.
Whoa, the moon shines bright on Albuquerque. Are you all a jerky from Albuquerque? Whoa, the moon shines bright on Albuquerque. Are you all a joykin' from Albuquerque?
What was that you were saying?
Oh, yeah. The other night
about this dream I was telling you about. Oh, what a lovely dream. Still dream about the girl in white. Again right there in my loving arms. Are you really? How much I'm really gonna miss her. Don't ever do it. Don't ever take her away.
Sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are blue.
Blue,
how much I love you.
Please don't take my
to the Merchant Marine Corps. And now comes the great test. This morning at breakfast, realizing I would work with Betty Hutton tonight, I took 7 vitamin B1 tablets. Over at Paramount, a fellow playing opposite her discovered that he had a shortage of B1, so he took it every day, and after 6 weeks doing those love scenes with Betty, you know what? He now has a shortage of A, C, and E. Here's Vivacious...
Thank you, Mr. Ameche, for that charming, charming introduction. It was charming of you, really, it was.
Hey, wait a minute, Betty. What's this highfalutin talk coming from you, the blonde bombshell?
Think of the past, my dear boy. Hutton has left the hoi polloi. From now on, I sing nothing but grand opera.
What?
Grand opera, you know, music with big fat dames.
That's a little more like it. Tell me, what brought about this amazing metamorphosis?
Metamorphosis?
Change. What makes you think you can sing grand opera?
Do you want to hear me?
Well, sure, go ahead.
What do you think of my execution?
Well, I'm in favor of it. Speaking of favors, why don't you answer this batch of mail and talk yourself out of that into a tune?
Okay, Mr. Bell. I'll wrestle a few tongue twisters. Thanks to Sarge McAvoy and the Hut 5 Commandos at 633 and the gang at Navy 12, Fuddy Duddy Ray Pantages at 942, and Sarge Eldon and friends in Alaska. Hello to the 4 British Hepcats at number 20 Mess. And lots of love to Sarge M. Geller. Geller signs off with first in Africa, first in Sicily, and hoping to be first in Berlin. Gee, that's great. My best to 2nd Platoon of the Anti-Tank Company at 29, and love to Machinist Mate First Class Paul Punk Harris and Artie on that sub-chaser. And to Homebrew Homer, John Collins, and Beer Barrel Brown, and Mickey Finn at 625. But thanks for writing, fellas. And backed up by the 43rd Army Air Force's Band of Gardner Field, here's a couple of feet from a movie I'm in.
Sit down for a minute. Gee, I'm ready to fall in a heap. Willie's been fed and I've tucked him in bed. Thank goodness the darling's asleep. He's a wonderful boy and a joy and a boon. Archie, you should have seen him this afternoon. Bang went the bridge lamp, down went the table, crash went the china tray. Body said, I couldn't help it, my walking horse ran away. Rip, rip went the curtain, wham went the window, crunch went the new buffet. And I heard him tell his daddy, my walking horse ran away. Somehow, Indians got into our front room. Our cowboy grabbed his gun and went boom, boom, boom. Like I'll soon be gray. But he smiles, and what's the difference? And maybe some Mother's Day. I'll remember when his rocking horse ran away. Got up early this morning, wore a flimsy negligee, had to hurry to fix the breakfast and get Daddy on his way. Figured I could get the paper so the neighbors wouldn't see. So I sneaked out on the porch, but very, very quietly. Wham! Went a dishpan, then came a holler, up went the neighbor's shade. It was Mother's little darling out on a commando raid. Came home late from a picture. I was tired, my shoes were tight. Took off my stockings, dropped my girdle, got undressed and pulled the light. Slipped into my nightgown, then tiptoed across the floor. Better have a look at Junior. So I peeked into his door. Clang, 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 went a cowbell, wing went a whistle. I nearly had a stroke. It was Mother's precious baby, just having his little joke. Always jumping up, breathing a peaceful sigh. There's G-Men, Copperton, Robertson, high home silver. Bam went the bookcase, food went the fruit bowl, boom went the glass bouquet. But he smiles, and what's the difference? day. I'll remember when. Bang went the lamp, down went the table, crash went the tray, rip, rip went the curtain, wham went a window, clang went a bell, wee went a whistle, bell went a bell, slam went a door. On that eventful day, when his rocket horse ran away.
Well, fellas, this is about all the time the law allows, and I see Ken Carpenter edging in to lock up the joint till next week, so we'll do a rapid fade about here. One little thing, though. A bunch of us on Command Performance were talking about the nicknames you guys dream up. Where you dig them up, we don't know. But we were wishing we had something to give away, like the commercial programs do, so we could start a nickname contest and give the winner a quart bottle of tonsil remover or a life-size picture of Gypsy Rose Lee in the flesh. Anyway, it would be interesting to make up a scrapbook of the slang and screwy names you guys dream up, so if you get any time, shoot us a sample of your lingo. We'll make use of it on Command Performance. Thanks again, fellas, and this is Don Ameche saying the best of the best from the USA.
This is Ken Carpenter snapping the latch with a closing remark that Command Performance is arranged through cooperation with the Hollywood Victory Committee and produced for you men and women of the Armed Forces of the United Nations by the Special Service Division of the War Department of the United States of America.